Scarlet. Let's go get him.
Give me that joy I can't explain. An extra piece that'll ease my pain. I want that love that'll never change. Give me that.
Give me that.
Give me that.
Give me that.
Give me that power to walk away.
Yeah.
When another God wants to take your place.
Let's go.
As much of you as I can take.
Whoa.
Give me that.
The show to end.
Uh-oh.
Get the actors off stage.
Uh-oh.
And let church begin.
Uh-oh.
Do you want a revolution?
Uh-oh.
You want to hear a new song?
New song.
Now, I want to talk to the saints of God today. And if you're not in a position to where you've submitted your all to God, then this is the perfect opportunity to do it. Today is the day of salvation as well. But there comes a time when those who are blessed of God, who have actually received Christ, that they need some meat of the word. They're drinking milk, and then, you know, we grow and we move into an area of maturity. Now, if we don't apply the principles of God's word, we'll stay as little babies. But I want to talk to you because when we talk about, as believers, our life in Christ, then we have a purpose. We have a perspective. And we've been called out of the world, and now we're joint heirs with God, with Christ, and God has His intentions for our life. We're not our own, the Bible says. We've been bought with Christ, but we hear these scriptures, and if you're not careful, it'll just become a language. It'll become just a cliche, and it never really dawns on us that we are living epistles. Other people want to look at you, they want to look at me, and they want to read the life of God as they look at our lives. And so I have to ask myself, Lord, what are people really reading when they see my life? When they see my attitude, what are they really? And that's a challenge, amen? Because guess what? All of us, we have some areas in our life that God is still shaping and He's still molding, and I'm not exempt from that. Every day I'm seeking the wisdom of God so that I'll learn how to love like Jesus loved. Jesus loved us in spite of all this junk that we do, even once we're saved. That's why we need God's grace, amen? Hallelujah. Now, I'm going to try to move fairly rapid because there's a lot of information. There are scriptures that I'm going to bring into the focus, but it's the one. Then you have no part of me. Wash everything about me, Lord. Wash everything. I don't want you to leave me. You wash their feet as an example of humility. Do we see that today? Do we see that today? If I can't be your servant, don't call me your pastor. Don't call me your bishop. Because that's unscriptural. You got to serve me, and I'm provoking you to serve me. Find you somebody else. Because God didn't call me to be served. He called me to serve. Now let me clarify this. Brother Darren, amen. You can still buy lunch for me. Amen. Saints of God, you can call me and say, come on, Pastor, come on over to the third place for dinner. That's okay. But when I got a mandate, And I got to start teaching the people. Put me first. And everybody else last. Even the children. See, I don't do that. See, there's a reverence that you give based on the anointing. Y'all get this. It's not something that has to be demanded, mother. It's something you earn. Your life speaks for you.
And sovereign God who predestined creation before time began. I want the God who with brilliance and elegance decorated darkness with stars. The God who orchestrates the future. At the same time, he knows where you are. Give me that God who supplies my needs, cause he owns all the cattle on the hill. And he's the God who wipes my tears and provides enough to pay all my bills. And give me that God, that's the God I'm talking about.
Give me that God,
that's the God I'm talking about.